Welcome back to onestoptutorials.com. Let's keep moving forward, and in this tutorial we're going to get the top bar. We're going to get this actual section in here, the sponsored links, okay? And a lot of this we've pre-built already, example over here. So make sure you're inside of the div ID right content, okay? So let's get coding. So div, we can make it an ID or a class, but let's make it a class just to be sure. And I'm going to call this top bar right, okay? And I'm going to close that, remembering inside of that, so that's going to be the green bar, okay? Inside of that, again, we have an h3, and I'm going to call it header text. Let's close that, and again, make sure, let me make some space here so you can see. Okay, make sure you're not inside of the div class top bar right content, that's the opening and closing, but make sure you're actually still inside of the right content. And this is going to be the div class, and this is going to be top bar content bg whatever, okay? Top bar, that's going to be the one with the green border, and inside of there we're just going to have some Google AdSense, so we don't really need to do much with that. So let us get into the style sheet. First thing, this is going to be, let me just make a note just so we know, start of right sponsor content. Okay, and while I'm here, actually, I'm going to call this header content. I'm going to name this sponsor links. Okay, so what do we want to do first? First, we want to do the top bar right. Okay, so, and that's a class, so top bar right, okay? And we need a background image, background URL, and that's the image of, let's go to thumb, top bar left, top bar under, top AdSense, no, top bar right AdSense, this one here, okay? And I want to know repeat, and you know what, I might even make it bottom left, keep it all the way down. Let's close it with a semicolon. Let's specify the width and the height, which is top bar right AdSense 170 by 36, so the width is going to be 170 pixels, and the height's going to be 36 pixels. Okay. Next, we had a, what do we have? We had a top bar right, and we had an H3 tag. Control V, Command V. That. Let's change that to H3, and we got so many H3s here that we could probably pretty much just copy these. I mean, it saves so much time. A lot of this is exactly the same, so I'm just going to copy that. I'm going to Control or Command V that in there. That's looking good. Let's have a look. Make sure everything is going to plan. Okay, I'm going to need a bit of margin at the top. So, let's go on the top bar right, margin top 10 pixels. Do a margin left, which is going to push it to the right. And I don't know, let's do 25 pixels. How are we looking? It's just a bit of play now. It's too much. Let's make it 15 pixels. Just sort of trying to get it in the center. Okay, looking good. So what's next? Next is top bar right. We've done the H3. Next is the actual, come to the code view here, and we need to do this one. Top bar content BG. Control or Command C that. Let's bring it into the CSS. What do we want to do with this? Well, pretty much, I know we want this to be a height of 600 pixels because it's a Google AdSense. We know the width is going to be, if we look at the top bar right, the width is 170. We need to take away 2 pixels because of the green border, one to the left, one to the right. So the width is going to be 168 pixels. And then basically, we just need that green border, which is here. I'm just going to copy that, saves us from typing. Control V, that should get that baby in there. Let's have a look. Okay, we need to apply the same amount of margin left here. margin left. That should make it the same. How are we looking? Okay, let's have a quick preview. And there's our sponsored links, and that's where the actual Google AdSense is going to go. So that was a quickie. That one didn't take long at all. This doesn't look even to me. Just doesn't look, and it looks different font. I want to keep it to continuity. So let me just keep this to continuity. What a big word I'm using here. Top bar. I just want to see what top bar was. Top bar, top bar. Be top bar. There's top bar, top bar H2. I'm going to copy all that actually. Top bar H2. And I'm going to put it in top bar right. I'm just going to paste all that in there. Okay, let's have a look again. Hopefully that's fixed the problem. That's better. So basically, go up to this one here. This is top bar. So you go to your style sheet, go to top bar. It's up here. In fact, top bar H2 you're looking for. This one here. You just copy all of that and paste it into this one here, top bar underscore right, and that will get that baby looking good. So let's have a look at what else we need to do here. Okay, what we want to do now is we want to do a footer, okay, because I know AdSense is going in here. If we want to move the whole section along a bit later on, we can, so it's not a problem. Let's actually get the footer in and see how we get on. So let's come to where do we want to put this footer? I'm going to put the footer on outside, divid, and I'm going to call this footer. And this is where the fun begins, where we might get a little bit of problem, but we will be able to sort it out. Let's, for the time being, just specify, it was an ID. Let's just specify margin 0 space auto, so we want it in the middle. Okay, we need to know the width of it because we're center aligning it. We need to know what the width is. The width's going to be the same as the header, which is 1,000 pixels. So width 1,000 pixels, and the height's going to be, let's just put 100 pixels in to start with. It's probably going to be probably more than that. Let's have a look, and you might notice that you can't actually see it. This is a common issue because we're floating everything above and below. Generally on footers, you always seem to need to add a clear both. What that does is push everything down. As you can see, there it is. To make it a bit easier for you to see, background color, I'm going to make it blue just for the time being, just so you can see what I mean. And there is our footer. So if I preview this, you'll notice our footer is underneath. If we don't add that clear both, let me just show you, take that baby out of there. This is actually one of the common questions I get. You'll notice that your footer's up here now. Okay, the reason being is that you need to add a clear both, meaning you need to clear this footer past all these float lefts, float rights and stuff like that. So that one bit of code, and like I say, this is one of the most common questions I get, clear both, that one bit of code will basically clear its way through and put your footer at the bottom of the page. Okay, so in the next tutorial we're going to come in, we're going to stylize some of our footer, we're going to get all that information done, and we're going to keep moving forward. Take it easy, guys and girls. Catch you very, very soon.